Part B, 1 6 grams of sulfur. Part C, 2 grams of calcium oxide. Part D, 4 grams of sodium hydroxide. But then with part A, we put the unknown on the right hand side and the known on the left hand side. So, oxygen molecule is like that, but it is diatomic. And here they are giving us the RMM. So we need to find the RMM, which is RMM is 16, then times 2 molecules, which gives us 32 grams. So therefore, I would say 1 mole. So we need the number of moles this time round. Therefore, I'm going to put the moles on the right hand side. So I say 32 grams of oxygen molecule contain 1 mole. Then if 32 grams contain 1 mole, what of the 1 gram? 1 gram of oxygen molecule contain, cross multiply 1 times 1, you over 32, all of this is in moles. Therefore, I need to find the number of moles of the required mass, which is 4 grams. 4 grams of oxygen molecule contain, you cross multiply again 4 times this, which is 1 times 1 over 32, again times 4 moles. So when you put this into the calculator, you're going to get 0.125 moles. Again, part B, that thing has to find the mass, the number of moles in 160 grams of sulfur. Part B, 160 grams of sulfur. So sulfur is again using the same statement by letting the relative atomic mass, which is 32, to the number of moles. We know that the relative atomic mass is equal to 1 mole. Therefore, it's 32 grams of sulfur contain 1 mole. So if 32 grams of sulfur contain 1 mole, what of the 1 gram? 1 gram of sulfur contain, you cross multiply 1 times 1 divided by 32, which is 1 times 1 divided by 32. This one gives us moles. Having known that, again we are going to cross multiply, find the number of moles in the required mass, which is 160 grams. So you say 160 grams of sulfur contain, what's my power saying? 1 times 1 over 32 times 160. This, all of this is in moles. At the end of it all, when you pull that into the calculator, we are going to get 5 moles. Think about that. Part C, we have 2 grams of calcium oxide. So, this calcium oxide. We first find the RFM of calcium oxide. We have RFM of calcium oxide will be, calcium is 40, is equal to 40 times 1, then plus oxygen is 16 times 1, which gives us 40 plus 16 gives us 56 grams. So, I can relate the relative formula mass to the number of moles, but remember I need the number of moles. I'm going to put the number of moles on the right hand side. So I say 56 grams of calcium oxide contain 1 mole, because this is the RFM. So if 56 contain 1 mole, what of 1 gram of calcium oxide contain, cross multiply 1 times 1 over 56, these are moles. So from there you can find the number of moles in the mass given, which is 2 grams. Therefore, I say 2 grams of calcium oxide contain. Let's multiply again by saying 1 times 1/56. Then times 2 times 2. These ones are moles. Therefore, I will get 0.036 moles. In part B, 4 grams of sodium hydroxide. Part B, 4 grams of sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide is NaOH. So the RFM of sodium hydroxide is given by sodium is 23, thymus is 1 atom, then plus oxygen is 16, thymus 1 atom, then plus hydrogen, which is 1, thymus 1 atom, giving us 23 plus 16 plus 1. This one will give us 39 plus 1 is 40 grams. We need to find the number of moles in 4 grams of sodium hydroxide. Therefore, I will say 40 grams of sodium hydroxide contain 1 mole. Now, if 40 grams of sodium hydroxide contain 1 mole, what of 1 gram of sodium hydroxide contain? Let's multiply 1 times 1/40. Now, if 1 gram contains this, what of the given mass, which is 4 grams? So 4 grams of sodium hydroxide are contained. Let's multiply again. 4, 1 times 1/40 times 4. These are moles. The answer that I don't get here is going to be 0.1 moles. Now, there are some notes here. Look at this. In our example, we have the given mass, it is 2, divided by the RAM. In our third example, we have the given mass, it is 4, divided by the RFM. So we discover that in general, to find the number of moles, we are going to divide the given mass divided by the relative atomic mass or the relative formula mass. When you divide by the relative atomic mass, that's when we have been given atoms. When we divide by the relative formula mass, that's when we have been given the molecules. For example, if we have 4 grams of oxygen molecule, 4 grams of oxygen molecule, and find the number of moles, we can say the given mass is 4, divided by the RFM, which is 32. The answer will be 0.125 moles. But usually we don't use this one in calculating. We can use these ones in our objective questions and use these ones, the first principles, in our structured questions.